श्रीमते रामानुजाय नमः। श्रीमान् वेंकटनाथार्य कवितार्किक केशरी वेदांताचार्य वर्यो मे सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि। श्रीमते निगमांत महादेशिकाय नमः। श्रीमते आदिवंशटगोपयतीन्द्र महादेशिकाय नमः। हाय किड्स, टुडे लेट बी कंटिन्यू नैरेटिंग वेरियस इंसिडेंट्स इन श्री वेदांत देशिकास लाइफ विच क्लियरली इंडिकेट हिज एक्सपर्टाइज इन वेरियस आर्ट्स, हिज भक्ति एंड कमांड ओवर नॉलेज अबाउट वेदास एंड दिव्य प्रबंधम एंड मल्टीपल लैंग्वेजेस। Once a sculptor offered to provide a base and asked him to make an image of himself. Desika made an image of himself, but when the sculptor tried to fix it on the base, he could not do so. He tried to chisel out a portion of the body of the image. Blood flowed from the corresponding part of the body of Desika. The sculptor admitted that the fault was in the base made by him. Desika fixed it up in the base exactly as it should be, like a professional sculptor. Later, this image was installed by Desika's son Varadacharya at Tiruvahindrapuram. Even today, anyone visiting Tiruvahindrapuram and offering prayers to the idol can never take their eyes off this marvelous Vigraha. Another incident. Once, when Swami Desika was staying in a village, he could not get anything to offer as naivedyam to the Lord. He just offered some water to the Lord and went to bed with an empty stomach and a heavy heart. Suddenly, he was awakened by a farmer who reported that a white horse was grazing the crops in his field. Swami understood that it was the lila of Lord Hayagriva and comforted the farmer. He asked the farmer to bring some milk and offered it to his Upasana Hayagriva Murti. Thereupon, the horse disappeared. Next morning, when the farmer went to the field, it was fully laden with fresh and green crop. Once a mason, wishing to test his skills as Desika was called Sarvatantra Sutantra, master of all arts, challenged him to construct a well with broken and irregularly shaped bricks that were supplied to Desika. Desika built a well almost in no time, which stands to this today as a testimony of his dexterity as a professional mason. Once, a group of Mayavadis landed in Srirangam for a debate condemning Ramanuja Darshanam. Pillilokacharya and others resorted to grand old master Sudarshana Bhattar for advice. Sudarshana Bhattar said that it was only Vedanta Desika who could save the situation and sent a letter to Kanchi inviting Vedanta Desika to face the opponents. On reaching Srirangam, Swami Desika fell at the feet of Sudarshana Bhattar and sought his blessings. Bhattar blessed him, saying that it was Nambarumal's command that he should re-establish our Siddhanta like our Ramanuja did earlier. Lord Ranganatha is referred as Nambarumal. The debate went on for 7 days, in which Swami demolished every single argument of the opponents. The Mayavadis accepted the defeat, became Sri Vaishnavas and his Shishyas. Alagiya Manavala Nayanar, brother of Pillai Lokacharya and our Swami, went to worship Lord Ranganatha. The Nayanar was captivated by the feet of the Lord and wanted to compose a stotra praising the same. Our Swami felt that the Divyamani Padukas of the Lord were equally captivating and offered to compose a stotram on the sandals of the Lord Ranganatha before sunrise of next day. Instantly, he commenced pouring out with bewildering rapidity an epic Paduka Sahasram and completed it well before sunrise. The 1000 verses of the epic is an example of literary excellence and lofty thoughts, a wonderful masterpiece of how a single subject like the sandals of Sri Rama could be expressed in so many different ways and yet hold up the imagination and interest of the audience. It was at this time that Periya Perumal, Lord Ranganatha, conferred the title Vedantacharya and Mahalakshmi Ranganayaki Thaya gave the title Sarvatvanta Swatantra. Sarvatantra Swatantra means master of all arts. Once instigated by some jealous people with the intention of embarrassing Sri Vedanta Desika, sent a bachelor to Swami for financial help for his wedding, knowing fully well that Swami had no money. Swami Desika took him to the Sanctum Sanctorum of the Divine Mother and sang the famous Sri Stuti. Immediately the sky opened up as it were and rained gold coins. Swami asked the bachelor to take them away, and the mischief makers were aghast at this wonder. At Tirunarayanapuram, his son Kumara Varadacharya delivered discourses on Tirukurugai Piran Pillan's commentary of Thiruvai Mozhi called 6000 Padi or Ayana Padi with the help of Swami Desika's notes called Nigama Parimalam. In 1342 AD, Hoysala King Veeravellala almost captured Kannanur fort near Srirangam after defeating Sultan's army, and at that time Sultan requested for peace. But Hoysala King Veeravellala was killed due to the wicked plans of Sultan's army general, who attacked suddenly when Hoysalas were taking rest. Vijayanagar kingdom was formed by King Harihara in 1336 AD. They took around 20 years to become a force in southern Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. Sri Vedanta Desika sent messengers to Gopanarya, who was the army general of King Bukka, who succeeded King Harihara in 1356 AD. Kambana, one of the princes of Vijayanagar kingdom, was in charge of southern Karnataka portions of the kingdom. Gopanarya worshipped Swami Vedanta Desika in Tirunarayanapuram, Melkote in Karnataka, and also frequently went to Tirumala and worshipped Lord Ranganatha over there. Gopanarya promised to Vedanta Desika that he will plan and advance gradually towards recapturing Srirangam. Once Desika's boyhood friend Vidyaranya, a court official of Vijayanagar kingdom, wanted to help Desika financially and invited him to the court for the purpose. But Desika declined and sent him a letter containing his famous Vairagya Panchakam, depicting his renunciation and detachment from the worldly wealth. Swami was requested to preside over and moderate a debate between the Advaita Vidwan Vidyaranya and Dvaita Vidwan Akshobhya Muni. After hearing the arguments of both, Vedanta Desika gave a ruling impartially that Akshobhya's views were in accordance with Pramana's, even though Vidyaranya was his boyhood friend, and settled the dispute. Finally, in 1371 AD, Vijayanagar army with the leadership of Gopanarya defeated Sultan's army and recaptured Srirangam. Sri Vedanta Desika and others came back to Srirangam with Lord Ranganatha, who had travelled to many places in the last 48 years. In the meantime, local people in Srirangam had created one new Ranganatha Vigraha, and there was a debate about who was the original Lord Ranganatha Vigraha. Gopanarya and others came and briefed on the challenge to Vedanta Desika, who was 102 years old at that time. Vedanta Desika suggested to find elders in Srirangam above 65 years of age who would have worshipped Lord Ranganatha earlier, can identify and endorse the Lord Ranganatha Vigraha we have got from Tirupati. They were not able to find anyone who can identify. Finally, they identified a washerman who was 90 years old. He said that he lost his eyesight at the age of 85. He said, "Even though I cannot see, I can still identify original Lord Ranganatha Vigraha." Earlier, every day, Lord Ranganatha's vastra, clothes, after Thirumanjanam, Abhishekam, were given to me. I used to immerse them in Kaveri river, squeeze them and drink that water which had a unique taste. If Tirumanjana Abhisheka is performed to both Lord Ranganatha Vigrahas and those clothes were given to me, I can identify the original Lord Ranganatha Vigraha. Tirumanjanams were performed to both Lord Ranganatha Vigrahas and clothes vastras were given to him. Sri Vedanta Deshika could have easily identified the original Lord Ranganatha Vigraha, but Sri Vedanta Deshika wanted the world to know the sincere bhakti of that washerman bhakta to establish the original Lord Ranganatha. It is believed that Vedanta Deshika authored a shloka on the fly for this occasion of Ranganatha returning back to Srirangam after 48 years. Haniyani lashringat yudirachita jagat ranjana anjanadre senjamaradya kanchit samaya madanihat yodat nushkansa tulushkan lakshmi kshamabhyam ubhabhyam sahanijanilaye stapayan ranganatham samyagvaryam saparyam kuruta nijayaso dharpano gopanarya. Meaning of the above shloka. The Lord Ranganatha with Sri Devi and Bhuma Devi, who was in the Anjanadri, one of the seven hills of Tirumala, was brought back via Senji to Srirangam by Gopanarya after defeating Sultan's army. Sri Vedanta Deshika authored 128 Granthams, 24 in Tamil, 1 in Prakrit, 32 in Manipravala. Manipravala means hybrid of Sanskrit and Tamil. 71 Granthams in Sanskrit, 27 Stotras, 5 Kavyas, 1 Drama, 25 philosophical works, 13 works in arts and science. Rahasyatrayasaram was authored by Vedanta Deshika when he was more than 90 years of age, which is a masterpiece and considered to be the flagship Grantham of Sri Vedanta Deshika. He was unimaginably brilliant in explaining very difficult philosophical concepts with simple examples. Our acharyas have shown many times how Sri Vedanta Deshika decides his choice of words, and even adding a character to the words or between words has invaluable meanings that we can understand and appreciate only when our acharyas explain to us. Having lived a full and rich life of 105 years and satisfied with his work on the earth, Swami Deshika had his last breath praying to Sri Ramanuja and his guru and maternal uncle Appullar by placing their padukas, sandals, on his head, which he kept on the lap of Varadacharya and his feet on the lap of Brahmatantra Swatantra Jiyar, the first Jiyar of Parakala Mat, while his shishyas chanted Tiruvai Mozhi and Upanishads. He attained Paramapadam in the month Kartigai in the asterism of Kartigai in 1373 AD. அருள் தரும் மாரண தேசிகனே எங்கள் தூப்புல் தேவே வரு கவிதார்க்கி கசிங்கமேவாதி அருவாழ் வருத்தாய் இருகையும் கூப்பி உரைக்கும் விண்ணப்பம் ஒன்று கேளாய் உருவயன கருளாய் எண்ணும் உள்ளமுன் தொண்டரையே தொண்டருகந்துணையடி வாழே நின் தூமுருவல் கொண்ட முகம் வாழே வாழி வியாக்கியா முத்திரைக்கை வந்திருநாமமும் வாழி மணிவட முப்புரினூல் கொண்ட சீர்தூப்புல் குலமணியே வாழினின் வடிவே. That's the story of greatness of Swami Vedanta Deshika. Thank you all. We will meet with another story in next few days. Stay tuned.